Hello, today I would like to talk about fetal echocardiography. Now, fetal echo has become something that is frequently done. It does not mean that the baby has a problem or has to have a problem for a fetal echo to be done. So, first question will be, why is a fetal echo done? So, a fetal echo is an examination of the fetal heart. Just like how an adult goes through an echocardiography, the fetus in the womb can also have a fetal echocardiography done. Now, this echo can be done for various reasons. One, it can be done when there are high risk factors, either in the mother or in the fetus. There can be maternal high risk factors like the mother being a diabetic, or there can be factors like the mother having some kind of autoantibody in the body which can cause problems like a heart block in the baby. Or there can be problems like there being the mother or other members in the family having had a congenital heart defect themselves. So it makes sense to check and see if the fetus is normal or also has a cardiac abnormality. So these will be maternal indications. In the fetus, if for any reason there is a high risk for chromosomal abnormalities or if there is any other associated defects, these associated defects might be major, might be minor, or might be just markers. But still, it would make a lot of sense to make sure that the heart of the baby is normal. When we talk about heart of the baby being normal, we are talking about the heart being normal structurally, the heart being normal functionally and physiologically. So we're looking at the heart, the structure, the various valves in the heart, the structure of the heart, the blood vessels coming into the heart, the blood vessels draining out of the heart. All of these comprise the fetal echo. In addition, we are also looking at how the heart is functioning, how the blood flow within the heart is happening, whether the pressure gradients are satisfactory, whether the pumping activity of the heart is normal. All these are important. Now, when we are doing a fetal echo, when we report a fetal echo, we report it in this manner so that all aspects of the fetal echo is covered. And when we are doing a fetal echo, when we're looking at the heart in a very early pregnancy scan, like for example a 12 to 13 week scan, it is possible for us to see the heart, but the heart per se is very small. It's just a little bigger than an orange seed. So in this situation, we can see the basic structure of the heart, in the sense whether the blood flow patterns into the heart is normal, whether the blood flow patterns out of the heart is normal, whether the blood flow through the major valves are normal. This is to be done in every first trimester screening. In patients who have high risk factors, like how I mentioned, there is a possibility where we can do an early fetal echocardiography. An early echo is done only in high risk patients. This is done around 16 weeks, between 16 to 18 weeks, before the anomaly scan or the target scan is done. This is because the heart is big enough to be examined and the structural aspects are complete. Ideally, if there is no major risk factor and if the echo can be postponed, the ideal time to look at the heart will be around 20 weeks. The reason why we choose around 20 weeks is again because of the various laws in the country. If a routine echocardiography is being done just to make sure that everything is all right, after the anomaly scan, around 24 weeks would be the ideal time to look at the fetal echocardiography. This is because the baby is big enough, the heart is big enough, and the cardiac function is quite well established. Things like the contractility of the heart muscle function is well established, and it is possible for us to examine it in detail. So echocardiography is now quite a common examination, but it is very important to remember that, like an ultrasound, echocardiography is very operator dependent. The quality of your report depends on who is doing it and how it is done. So it is important it is done by somebody who is trained in fetal echo, like a fetal medicine specialist. Because if there is an abnormality, correct and complete reporting is important. Thank you.